What do you got on you? Suppressed powerful pipe pistol. Yeah, that's not really something I'd want. Maybe the suppressed part, but not the pipe pistol thing. Oh no. Oh, we found out where they kept all their pills. Did they eat them? That's the important question. It always is the important question. I mean, maybe I'm used to other types of media, but it always happens, right? Someone goes crazy, starts eating other humans.
Although, to be fair, these guys aren't humans, they're ghouls.
Hancock, you'll be fine. I have ran away. And you're a ghoul. And the kid's a ghoul. So what the hell happened over here? Who shot down these guys? There's a Brotherhood senior scribe. If he shoots at me, he's just gonna die immediately. It says he's hostile. See? Hey there, friends! It still says you're hostile. Why?
Hi. The Institute and their technological abominations need to be stopped at any cost.
Okay. Well, I'm glad there are some survivors. Well, the question is, who the fuck killed you? Or killed your vertebrae? Who killed your pilot? Or shot it down, pretty much? Raiders? We still don't even have a name for this place yet. Hyde Park! It was definitely Raiders. We gotta get to some kind of fucking place up there. I hate flooded places, damn it. Can't do anything here. Can't shoot. Nothing. There we go. Ooh, he almost got me! It was behind a painting! Raider veteran! Alright. What level are you guys, anyways? Level 39. I guess that's fine. Hey, shout out your knee! I hope you enjoy that! Kid, do you want armor? I got plenty of it on me. It's a cool little combat helmet. If you're legitimately a pre-war kid, you'd enjoy it. You know, I like how we call it pre-war. Right? I don't think it's really pre-war. It's more like during war. I mean, there's constant battling going on between everybody, so I mean, it just seems weird to call it pre-war when it's not. More like just pre-bombs? But I guess that's just arguing semantics. It always is. Can't believe there's no Raiders alive out here. They got shot at by vertebrates. They're still getting shot at by my own dudes. Hey there. Bye-bye! Oh, I guess you can leave your head here. That's cool. No, damn it, he fell down. I wanted to take his loot. Although there is a legendary raider around here. Hey there. What do you got? Assassin's 44 pistol does 50% more damage against humans. Neat. Not what I want, but I will take it. Well, Hancock will take it.
Hey. See if she had anything.
Yes, and now navigate himself all the way around this place without using jumping ability. He doesn't have that ability. He's an AI. He's not smart enough to pathfind.
That's it.
Ooh, hey, heavy combat armor chest piece. Not what I need, because I already have a heavy combat armor. I guess I could take it. Just take everything. Let me drink some alcohol. Or just eat grilled rat steak. Boom. Note, or signed your neighbors. Looking forward to seeing you signed your neighbors. Uh-oh. I'm assuming that the neighbors refer to the people at the quarry we just killed. So, whoops. I guess the only way they're actually seeing each other is in
nice.
Whatever kind of pre- or post-death thing they believe in.
I'll see you in hell.
Alright, well, I guess so. I gotta go to heaven for a bit, party for a while, and then yeah, I guess I'll go down there. Just for a vacation. But you can enjoy hell, go for it! And we're gonna take this assassin's pistol because we don't trust Hancock to actually get up here.
And that's time to jump into the radiation-filled water! What do you got on you?
Not much.
Damn it.
So is there anything to this place besides the fact that it's raider-filled? Like, are there notes about this place? Will there be a terminal barely above the water talking about rising sea levels? And how the polar ice caps will melt if nuclear water were to break out? I don't know why they complain so much about cover. Especially when you're in power armor. We're walking in cover, my friend. Trust me, we'll be fine.
Oh, hold up. Gotta take out this fusion core. It's at 5%.
And they sell for good money.
Yeah.
I wonder where the kid went. He's supposed to just be following me, so we'll just hope he teleports. What if he just goes, this isn't the way to Quincy? Ooh, hello. There's a radio tower in front of me. I'm gonna mark that place because I do want to actually get to Quincy before I go all over the place. There's the kid. Let me check this place out a little bit more. I feel like there has to be something here more than just, he killed raiders and there's a safe there. Right? Another workbench. If I find a cooking thing, I should probably try and use it to see if I have enough materials for
a squirrel stew.
Because being able to get more XP is nice. Every little bit counts. Oh, if only I wasn't so stingy with who I romanced. Then I could just sleep anywhere and get a 15% lover bonus. But I'd rather be in a bromance rather than a romance with my fellow men.
That way we could just be cool with each other. Fucking Hancock and MacReady, badasses.
And then there's Preston. I guess dance. So considering there is another vehicle around here, does that mean we have a power armor laying about? No. Not seeing one, really. But maybe there's one in the church. Hello. Minuteman. Hey, my own guys, although they're level 5. That doesn't inspire much in me.
Hi.
Nothing's getting by me,
hey,
sir.
Nothing new to report, Joe. Hey there.
This site belongs to the Minuteman.
Hey there. Got the area covered.
Okay, that's good. It actually would be cool if I could clear out an area of raiders and have it permanently covered by Minutemen. Like, not as a settlement, just as a place with Minutemen. But we can't do that. In fact, there's a lot of disappointing things involving, like, settlements and everything else. I mean, the way you figure, I'm a pretty important figure for a lot of stuff. I'm the general of the Minutemen. I can work my way up through the Brotherhood, work my way up to the Institute. But I never really get a chance to be like, I've got an army. And I just send my army out to different places to do whatever. I mean, as the Minutemen especially, you'd think you'd be able to go, hey, alright, Minutemen, I'm gonna need you to go check out Quincy and see what you can find there. And then you can kind of like check in on your Pip-Boy and have them report to you over message systems. That'd be cool. You could check in and see what kind of loot they got. And if they couldn't unlock certain safes, that'd also be cool. If you could have things marked by those scouts for you to check out, like, oh, there might be good loot over here. Oh, thank you, Minutemen. I'll make sure to give you an extra powerful gun. And that'd be nice. It'd be a nice exchange of things. I just want more reasons to give a shit about my Minutemen. And or to give them things.
Go away, Rain. You make life so hard.
You know, it'd be really cool if one day there's an open world game with so much realistic shit going on that, like, a flood could happen. That would be cool. Like, legitimately, while you're walking around in the world, it rains for a really long time, suddenly the area starts to flood and you have to reconsider your combat opportunities. And it even floods inside of buildings. But that would be way, way off. What the fuck is that? Lightning or nuclear explosion? I just don't know.
They're gonna shoot us!
Alright. Okay, that is definitely a mini nuke. Or mini nuclear explosion. Whoops. Why is that? Why are there things going on in Quincy when I have to take this kid over here? Ah, because gunners. Yeah, that explains everything. Gunners are dicks. Let's do a save before I get in trouble. Fucking damn it! Buddy, I just hit your head with a fuckload of lasers. There you go. The death befitting of someone out here in the wasteland. Lasers to the face. Glad you guys came back around the corner to fight me rather than the people you were initially fighting against. Oh, were they fighting against a traitor caravan? Jeez. Run, get out of here, Spot! Is that Cricket? Oh my god, Cricket! That's a really random happenstance. Why the hell are you all the way out here? I guess she's just gotta sell her merch to everybody. Oh shit, ah! Hey there, Al! Okay. Do you really want to do this? Do you want to pursue this option? Because, this is a really bad idea. Punch me again. Alright, alright. She's committing to it. That's what's gonna happen today. Let us have ourselves a couple of things. We will take ourselves some buff out, buff tats. Jet. Mentats. Psycho. Psycho buff. Come on, man, you're supposed to be getting super damaged. All right, now you're gonna bleed to death. That's a cute plasma gun you got there. Doesn't matter much now that you're dead. How about some explosive shots? Oh my god, how many gunners are in this fucking place? Kid, I don't think you're gonna find anybody alive here. Except for raiders. Glorified mercenary raiders. Man, they all have fucking plasma guns. I mean, it's a good thing that they're taking themselves out, but I'd rather fight against a bunch of people with power armor. Now that would be interesting. You get to level 50 and suddenly every gang's got themselves packed up in armor. Sure, it'd make power armor not as, interesting, but if you made it like raider gear and like gunner gear, then it wouldn't mean stuff that you'd want, just stuff that makes them a little bit more resilient to you fucking their day. Hey, legendary gunner. Okay, here's what's gonna happen here. I'm gonna shoot out your left arm. And then I'm gonna shoot out your right arm. Or not. Never mind. I just wanna like cripple him and make him drop his gun. Why can't you let me do that? Ow, ow, jeez, they are lighting me up. Oh look, another person of power armor! Ow? Hello? Okay, alright. I'm being shot at from a bunch of different directions, so I'm just gonna go ahead and take advantage and shoot everybody myself in this super slow-mo time. Okay, are you good? Is everybody fine? No, you're still here. Here, have a crit shot to your face. Jeez. This may or may not be the last guy. Fortifying metal right arm. Meh. Look how much my strength goes up with all the shit I've taken. Holy crap. Here's a heavy combat right arm piece. I think I already have something like that, but we'll take it anyways. First comes to worst, we're gonna drop all this stuff on the ground for Hancock to pick up. And then I can just jump cut it all the way. If by a lot of effort you mean a whole lot of people, then I guess. Oh look, the plasma mine, that's not what I want. Holy shit though, you aren't kidding, there are a ton of things, I just wanna kill the turret. There you go. I don't know who else is out here, but holy crap. Oh yeah, my mini nuke launcher that blows out people's ears as well as the enemies. I'm not gonna be using that much. Alright, while we're here, I might as well eat some food. Hell, I'll even eat radiated food. Why not? Oh, because they suck, that's why. Okay. Squirrel on a stick. Somebody's thing was moving. That means we have at least one gunner still alive, and then probably a turret. No, they're both moving. Interesting. So we saw on one of the dude's bodies, there's a tape from Tessa. And then we start getting punched by this chick named Tessa anyways, so this'll be interesting. Now, Gunner, are you in here? Yes, he is. Hey!
Don't let them hurt me!
Kid, you're gonna have to learn to suck it up. In this world, everybody's out to kill you. Although apparently your mission leads directly here. Oh wait, I don't have his mission selected actually. What am I talking about? kid in the fridge. All right, where am I supposed to go for that? This building or the one ahead of it? Okay. I might as well drop off this kid and deal with everything else afterwards.
So are his mom and dad gonna actually be alive? Will we get a happy ending to bringing this Billy kid around the wasteland? In this harsh rain? This irradiated land of doom? We'll find out, because there's a house perfectly standing ahead of us. It's got lights and everything. Candles capable of weathering a storm. Holly's terminal, or Hollis? Setting up defenses. Looks like we're just, Looks like we just got here in time. We ended up taking a group of gunners from behind as we came into the town. Took out about a third, but at least a dozen ran off. Mayor Jackson was practically in tears when we came up. Even let us use his own house as a barracks. Gotta say, it's nice to find the Minutemen welcomed like we were back in the day for, like in the old days for a change. Preston has been helping them get some better walls up. What? And the town mechanic has been invaluable. He even has a couple suits of power armor. If he can get them up and running, it'd be a huge help. If we don't have near enough manpower to hold the town, if the gunners return in force, but I can't tell anyone that. I sent out any word to try to get the reinforcements from any other Minutemen out there. I hope at least Colonel Marbury will be willing to help. Were we ever told about Quincy by Preston? Because we were, whoops. I didn't know we'd actually come around to this place. We've gotten the walls in pretty good shape and filled the stairwell out the monorail platform. I've had Sturgis working on getting some walkways set up across the rooftops. Figure if they manage to breach the wall, we may be able to retreat up there for the counterattack. The gunners attack almost daily now, but we've got food and supplies enough that we can probably wait them out. Unfortunately, my call for reinforcements has been disappointing. Not a single person has shown up. Betrayed. Today has been a terrible turn of events. One of our own, a veteran named Clint, showed up at the gate. I thought at first they had come to tell us the reinforcements were on the way, but it turns out the bastard had changed size. He's apparently leading this group of gunners who have been laying siege. He actually had the nerve to try to convince the mayor and me to stand down. I politely informed him that there was not a chance in hell of that happening, and what I would do to his traitor's ass if he showed up again. If someone of his experience is leading them, we'd better be ready for anything. Yeah, like actually losing.
Most folks that run with me don't live out the day. I'm impressed.
Hey man, I've got my armor. The armor definitely helps out with everything. Maybe a little bit too much. Whenever I'm not in my armor, my health drops really, really quick. So...
Now that looks good on you.
It'd be interesting to roll around the game again like we used to. Back in the days when I was like, I don't want to use this because my fusion cores might run out. Now it's more like, I just keep on using it. All the time. Never stopping. Well, so we gotta get up to the rooftop and hope it doesn't start raining again. I slept in a bed down in that building for 24 hours and I woke up to it raining again. I was like, oh my god. So I almost... If the rain had lasted too long, I would have lasted pretty much 2 days. But it did stop raining previously, just not an ideal hour. I want to go visit Billy's family, like, at a timely hour. You know, in the middle of the day, like right now. Not so much at like 8 o'clock at night. That seems a little bit off. But I do still want to check everything out. Okay. Well, I'm a Murphy staff. Oh, okay. All right, Stash. So, Tessa, I want to find out about her. Where is the tape that talked about it? I think it was in this building. Or not. This is really far in. Okay, definitely not in that building. Who the fuck had the tape? It was someone definitely over here. Oh well. Let's see what she has. T-51B torso, meh. I guess I could tell Hancock to pick it up.
See if she had anything. See if she had anything.
I can do that.
Besides that, I need everything else. Okay. Maybe I picked up the tape by accident? Nope, here we go. It's Baker, the dude who was on the rooftop with a fat man. Oh, that was a fat man? Oh no! He was shooting out regular missiles. Right? Right? I don't know. We'll take it. All right. Tessa's tape. Or Tessa's hollow tape. I have to get it right. Note. Tessa.
Fuck you, Baker. It's been over 3 years since I was in the gang, and I've been working my ass off same as you. And this Minuteman asshole just turns traitor, and Captain West gives him command of the unit? It's bullshit, and you know it. You can't tell me you trust this guy. I may have been a raider, but I never rolled in my people the way Clint did. He's keeping us separated so that when he puts a gun at the back of your head, I won't be there to help you. Watch your back, Baker. Tessa out.
Okay. Obviously, they never did betray each other. Because we found them and they were all together, so they had that going for them.
Let's see if we can find any other terminals.
Stories. Nope. Teacher.
That's
there
it.
We go. Nah, I was hoping that actually have like a story thing to it. It's just a safe. Billy, don't worry. Your mom and dad are totally not in that fighting that we hear going on. In fact, they're perfectly waiting in a building, which was kind of creepy. I mean, really? They just stayed there for 200 years? I would have gotten bored. I would have left. Joined up with a raider group or something. Not stay in the same house for 200 years with not much there at all. I still don't trust it. I'm still being really suspicious about things. Now, I'm still trying to get up to there because we did kill another dude in power armor. And I think that was the Clint dude. Maybe he has it. Tape on him too. I just don't know how to get up there. Okay, alright. We have to follow these little panels all the way up, and maybe we'll find an elevator. Or just another ledge. Or just more dead bodies from everything. Nope, I looted that guy, actually. Oh, yeah. I came up here and then just didn't go up. Jeez.
Hey. Grab anything useful.
You got it.
Let's see if my FPS will go up while I'm up here, because I notice it kind of dragging down. We want to go up to 59. Uh-huh. All right. 56. Can we get 56? Yep, 57. That dynamic shadow booster. That is so nice. Even if it takes a while. And then we drop it back down. Okay.
It's so quiet without all the cars.
I suppose? Yeah. I mean, there are plenty of quiet places, I'm sure, pre-war. Although they were quiet because there were no cars there, so yeah. Yep, there's Clint. Doesn't even have anything cool on him. He just has a whole bunch of T-50 gear. Alright. Hancock, take it.
See if he had anything worth taking.
I can do that.
Take everything off of him.
Hey.
What do you need?
Check it out.
Bingo.
See if there's anything there.
Good.
Take anything good. Grab that.
I hope we find out what happened to my mom.
Get that.
Bingo.
I hope we find out too. Maybe they joined up with a raider group.
What you got, friend?
Maybe they left this area. Ooh, gunner terminal.
Bingo.
Ballistic weapons permanently do 5% critical damage.
That wasn't any good.
It would actually be cool if I could read these.
Heads up. Pick that up.
You know, like you could read the books inside of Skyrim. I'd like to read comics. They would catch my interest generally. Okay, what do we got here?
Hey.
Personal logs from Lieutenant Clint.
Colonel Hollis. Shame I couldn't convince Colonel Hollis to see me, see reason. But the attack plan worked all the same. Once we blew the support on the highway and took the high ground, there was nothing they could do. Garvey managed to escape with a group of the settlers, but the rest was just a bloodbath. I had them capture Colonel Hollis alive so I could prove to my new troops that I'm done with the Minuteman. Even when I put the barrel to his head, he still refused to see that this is just how the world works. If you want to bring order out of the chaos, you need strength to do it. The Minutemen don't have it anymore. The Gunners do.
Captain West assures me that the troops he's given me in exchange for breaking the siege will obey the chain of command, but two of the more senior troops are proving difficult. The detachment I sent after Garvey returned yesterday, they managed to pick off several more of those settlers before losing them in Jamaica Plains. Tessa's complained that we let some of them get away, but she's still thinking like a raider. The Minutemen are done. Colonel Hollis was the last lead they had of any worth, and Preston certainly isn't going to be a leading of a counterattack with a bunch of wounded women and children.
Definitely not any children.
We've got our main cap set up on the freeway here, so we can't be taken the way the Minutemen were, and I managed to get the radio tied into an old radio tower to establish contact with GNN. Tessa and Baker had a long talk with Captain West, and while Baker had fallen into line, Tessa seems to be even more subordinate. Now that we're pretty well established and the troops are done setting up camp, I'm going to have to find other work for them to do. If they're busy, Tessa won't have time to rile them up. Maybe if I can keep her out of camp for a while, the others will follow Baker's lead and stop questioning my commands. Captain West also said to check with the medic to get my blood type tattooed. Seems unnecessary if the jester will convince them, it's probably worth a bit of pain.
Say what? Why would you need your blood type tattooed on you?
Obviously, they just have certain reasons. Maybe that is an actual tradition, but it just seems weird. Like,
yeah, I gotta let people know my blood type so they can take it from me eventually.
I sent some scouts down the highway to check for any nearby threats, but the only other thing nearby seems to be the quarry up the inlet. Looks to be a group of raiders, but with a good sniping position on the freeway. Oh, but with a good sniping position on the freeway, they wouldn't dare try to start a fight with us. Baker fired off a few rockets down at them, nothing major, just to make sure they know what they're dealing with. The factory. I sent Tessa out with a squad to scout out to the south, mostly to get her out of my hair for a while. They've reported that there's not much out there in the marsh other than an old factory. Looks to be inhabited by the Greenskins. They might cause a problem eventually, but for now, I don't think we need to pick a fight when we've got prisoners to deal with.
Atom Cats.
Turns out there's a group living at the garage out on the peninsula, calling themselves the Atom Cats, and they seem to be a pretty tight crew. The scouts have reported that their external fortifications are fairly weak, but they have several suits of power armor. Normally, I'd say it isn't worth the trouble, but with the troops angry about losing the prisoners, it might be the distraction they need.
So, what about Atom Cats?
Looks like my hometown. This is Quincy.
Oh, really?
Hey, Billy.
I hope it doesn't take too long to get to my house.
Too bad your house is legitimately outside of Quincy, not directly in it. Ugh. So, what about Atom Cats? Atom Cats Garage. Interesting. I'd be up for checking out that place and seeing what kind of power armor they have. I like how we have this place over here, the Warwick Homestead, just really far out, and we can make it a settlement. And we have an island next to it, too. I wonder how much is actually out here in this little swamp land. As I think I said beforehand, I have been down here, but there wasn't much that I saw, so... There could be a whole lot of nothing, or there could be a whole lot of something. Only way to find out is to explore properly. I hate when I get in power armor to try and increase my carry weight, and I still have walking on, and I'm like, whoa, nope, looks like I'm over encumbered. And then I press the button and go, wait, nope, we're good. It's a muscle memory now for me to do that. As soon as I see them slow down, I'm like, I just start spamming caps, like, please let me run. I like having an actual speed to me. But it'd be nice if I could just see something on the screen like, oh, you're just walking. Just have like a light turn on. Walking mode on. I guess that'd be kind of weird. It's not really a mode, it's just you choosing to walk on your keyboard. People with consoles wouldn't really be having that issue because they'd just be using their Xbox One controller or their PS4 controller.
You just say the word if you want to take a little chem break.
Heads up.
A little something to liven up the day.
Thank you, Hancock. I'm a big fan of free drugs. Either because they give me lots of money or because I can kill a lot of people.
For getting locked inside of that fridge.
I feel kind of stupid for still thinking that maybe you don't have something going on with you, buddy. It could just legitimately be a really happy tale. Kid gets locked into
a fridge for 200 years, becomes a ghoul, and his parents are still legitimately right around the corner. Yay, everyone's happy. But we'll see. Hello, Terminal. Long's Terminal. Mama Murphy. Oh, June. I can't believe Mayor Jackson is actually trying to get the Minutemen out of here based on Mama Murphy's drug-crazed hallucinations. Marcy tried to explain to him that she's just an old loon, and that we've been refusing to sell her chems anymore, but she's even got the Sturges convinced. Now we're gonna have to board and feed a bunch of freeloaders with laser muskets for nothing in return. Kyle's all excited, and I'm gonna have to break it to him that the Minutemen aren't actually like the stories he's heard. She was right. I can't believe it. She was actually right. Sloan and Irma were working making repairs to the walls and saw them sneaking around by the old warehouse. We tried to scare them off, but they were still advancing on the monorail stairs. Then, just when it looks like they were actually going to break through, the Minutemen actually showed up and drove them off. They're led by a man named Colonel Hollis, and Kyle is completely awestruck. Said he's going to join them when he gets older and has been following them around like a puppy. Kyle's hurt. I can't believe this. None of the reinforcements Captain Hollis promised were on their way have shown up. The gunners have been trying to find a way to get through the wall daily now. To make matters worse, while Kyle was following the Minutemen patrols around, he caught a bullet in the leg. It only nicked the bone, but he's gonna have trouble walking. If we even make it through this somehow, something's up. Something's going on. We thought at first that another of the Minutemen had showed up, since it looked like Colonel Hollis recognized him. The two of them went off to talk with Mayor Jackson in private. Not 10 minutes later, the men left, and Colonel Hollis followed him to the wall, shouting about what he would do to deserters. Was that guy one of the Minutemen or not? June. They made chems. You know, speaking of the Longs, what is up with them? I am still getting bad talked by, Mrs. Long. I don't remember her name. I don't even want to remember. But every time I go there, she's like, do I look like I need to be nice to you? Like, why? I've set up a pretty awesome area. In fact, Sanctuary Hills has been attacked maybe once in the, like, 80 plus hours I put into Fallout 4. And yet she doesn't change her mind for anything. It'd be nice if I could actually do something to fix that problem. Oh wow, another terminal right around the corner. Police terminal! Oh boy, I wonder if this place is, got another Eddie Winters case. Just let me type, dammit! Huh? Goddamn Clint. Oh, this is recent. Okay, the Scorps. This is useless. We went down in the parking lot and killed several of the Scorps that came out. But there seem to be just as many today. We keep killing them, but they keep coming back. If we just keep them away, they seem to leave us well enough alone, but Clint wants them cleared out of here. Baker. Rigged up some explosives at the parking lot so I could take a break and get up to the camp for a bit. The power armor we found in the church has taken a beating from the Scorps, so Baker helped me rig up some better armor for it. I was about to tell him how I feel about him, but the detachment we sent after the settlement showed up. Kinda lost the mood at that point. Aww. Goddamn Clint. I can't fucking believe this. That asshole Clint just let those Minutemen get away with the settlers. He says they gave him the slip, but how do we know he isn't playing one side against the other? He betrayed the Minutemen, how can we trust that he isn't betraying us now for a better deal? I still can't believe Captain West gave that asshole the command. So, okay. Who is this guy? I guess we'll have to see. Baker's holotape.
Look, Tessa, the orders come down straight from Captain Wes. Clint has the command here, and that's just how it is. If you keep running your mouth off, he's gonna make an example of you to show that he's still in charge. And why do you think he picked you to deal with those Scorps down at Super Duper Mart? Now, maybe you got away with that shit back when you were running with Raiders. The Gunners stick to the chain of command. Besides, we wouldn't have been able to take Quincy without him. You wouldn't have that sweet power armor, so get over it. Baker out.
Okay. I'm just confused because... So Baker's terminal, if we assume that's Baker's terminal, then Baker... wrote an article about Baker? So Baker helped me rig up some better armor for it, but I was about to tell him... Oh, wait, nope, alright. I just had to... do a little bit of context. The tape was inside of this terminal because it's Tessa's terminal. She listened to Tessa, or Tessa listened to Baker's tape on her terminal, and she wanted to tell Baker.
For locking myself in that fridge.
She wanted to tell Baker how she felt about him. Aww. Well, they're both dead. They can both do whatever the hell they want to each other, wherever the hell they went.
If it exists.
I like how I made it daytime so I could come here during the daytime, but I dilly-dally enough that it doesn't even matter. Whoops. Is that a whole factory building? Oh, hello.
Mom? Dad? Are you in there?
Billy? Billy?
Please don't tell me it's about to rain again. Oh my god. Oh my god.
I guess Cindy is probably dead too. She lived on my block. She was a year older than me.
Wow, Billy, way to really drop something depressing on me. Alright, we're gonna run to your house, kid. I have some loot that I really wanted to pick up, but fucking weather doesn't want to agree with me. I can't believe it started to fucking rain as soon as we came right back to this house. Okay, we have a save right out of here. We'll see what happens. Maybe RNG will be on our side. I just want to hear a conversation between this kid without it being
Mom?
Like,
whoa! Dad? Are you in there?
Billy? Billy?
Son? Is that really you?
It's me. It's really me.
Oh my god! We thought you were dead.
What happened to you? You're all burned up like me.
We're ghouls, Billy. The radiation changed us. Looks like it did the same thing to you.
Don't worry about it, Billy. Your dad and I don't care what you look like. We still love you.
I love you too, Mom. I missed you guys. It's been so long.
Thank you for bringing us back our little boy.
Yeah?
Is that
you
it?
You there, nope. In the house. I want those ghouls, especially that kid. You can give them up peaceful-like, or die trying to save them.
That's the man that tried to buy me.
Oh my God.
They won't take us, Carol. At least not alive. Billy, get upstairs.
The house is empty. Looks like they left in a hurry. Over my dead body, these people are under my protection.
Over my dead body? These people are under my protection.
I'll wear your eyeballs around my neck!
Well, that's an interesting way to threaten me. I'll wear your eyeballs around my neck! Oh, man. Railing saved your life, Bullet. That's okay. I've got plenty more where that came from. So it looks like he has some friends, but that's fine. We can deal with them in the same manner. I wasn't expecting to get attacked.
Should have stayed gone.
Come on, Gunner Lieutenant, keep yourself still behind some cover. Not like that.
Why don't
people
just leave
him alone? Just fuck it. Eventually, I just shot his butt. I can't see. Fuck this guy. Whatever. I'm trying to, like, shoot his butt out so I can finally finish him off. But nope. He's too much behind cover. Did my rat stag run out? Yeah, it did. Not that it really matters. Because I'm not in power armor, so, we're just gonna keep on taking stuff. Buff out. Alright. We're gonna go talk to the Peabody family, but first I want to see what this guy had on him. Not much. For someone who's like, I'm gonna wear your eyeballs around my neck, he really didn't...
Hey.
...have good gear on him.
See if he had anything worth taking.
But I can take stuff from everybody else, hell yeah. You know, besides the fact that you look ugly as all sin, it must be nice to be your ghoul. Like, in terms of just survival things. I don't think you even need to eat as a ghoul. But if you do want to eat or drink or whatever, you could probably have anything. Just be like, oh man, look at all this irradiated water around here. Doesn't even matter. I'm a ghoul.
Thank you for bringing us back, our little boy. And saving us from that man.
So, how did you end up as ghouls?
We didn't make it to the shelter in time.
The door was shutting as the bombs fell. We both must have taken a lot of radiation.
I guess we were some of the lucky ones. Most folks die instead of becoming ghouls. Must be something in both our genes.
So that's why you guys look like me.
Yeah, Billy. That's why. Although it's really more why you look like us.
We wandered for a while, but eventually came back here. We've been living here ever since. Not really anywhere else to go.
Let me thank you. Take this.
Yes.
Well, thank you, guys.
Hello.
Thank you for saving Billy.
Hey.
Glad you were here when Bullet and his gunners showed up.
You know what his name is?
Where did I put that?
He didn't say his name, right? He just kind of goes, hey, I want the kid and everybody else!
I never thought I would see my mom and dad again. Thanks.
You're welcome, Billy.
Hey.
Why do I talk to them so weird?
Hey.
Hello! Alright, well, we got that mission out of the way.
Go outside and play. All my friends are dead. It's almost like being back in that fridge.
Hey, at least you got your mom and dad. That's more than a lot of people can say out here in the wasteland. God damn, everyone has a tragic story out here. Even my guy has a tragic story. Got locked up in the vault, slept for 200 years, and as soon as I fucking woke up, my wife got shot in front of me and my kid was stolen! So be happy. Also, my kid's the head of a really, really shitty organization, which had potential to be really, really good, but they squander it. I'm being like, wow, morals don't exist anymore. We don't need them. So what is this building? Poseidon Energy. Well, that sounds like it'll have cool shit in there. Okay. I'll check that out soon, but I actually want to drop some stuff off because we just have way too many things on me. So to the sanctuary we go!